Hey fishermen, Aqua Duelist here, and the Mako Support just doesn't stop coming. We got a brand new retrain of Amphibious Bugroth MK3, so let's go ahead and jump into this. Alright, so the new card is officially called Amphibious Bugroth MK11. I think that's kind of funny since the newest Mortal Kombat game that's out right now is Mortal Kombat 11. Now, if you look pretty closely, I'm pretty sure that's actually Sub-Zero in the cockpit piloting this thing, so, you know, that's pretty freaking dope. We're doing, you know, crossover with Mortal Kombat. But, so it's a level 5 water machine monster, 1850 attack, 1500 defense, and its effect is, if Umi is not on the field, this card gains 700 attack, but it can't attack directly. If Umi is on the field, you can target one face-up non-water monster and destroy it. You can only use that effect once per turn. Honestly, for being a retrain of Amphibious Bugroth MK3, which, yes, I'm just going to say it's a retrain of MK3, because design-wise, this thing's closer to MK3 than the, you know, the old non-effect fusion. Just saying it, guys. This retrain is ass. Straight up, that first effect just doesn't need to be there whatsoever, I feel. I get it. It's like an insurance policy kind of thing there. Your opponent pops Umi. That, you know, it becomes 700 attack stronger, so it becomes 2550. Like, whoop-de-doo, what's that really gonna do for you? It, you know, this card has no self-protection, so yeah, that's not really gonna get you anywhere. Your opponent still will be able to run over it with their extra deck stuff, so yeah. Then there's also the effect where, you know, you just target and face up non-water monster and then you destroy it. I hate that effect. It targets and it destroys. It's 2022, and a lot of cards these days just protect themselves from being targeted and or protect themselves from being destroyed. So they either do or both, which the fact that this card says both target and destroy really just fucking sucks. Honestly, it is the worst monster removal that, you know, Mako currently has, I feel, you know, that got announced, essentially. You know, I'd rather really just play three Fury Kurushin with some Torrential Tributes, which Fury Kurushin's not even bad at all. It was, I would say, probably the worst one before this got announced, and I'm just gonna straight up say it, Fury Kurushin isn't even bad at all. Like, it's a pretty good card. So, yeah, we essentially just got shitty monster removal, which we already have access to a lot of monster removal that's actually pretty good. So I feel like this retrain wasn't needed. You're going to get more use out of MK Bugroth 3. Am I going to pick this card up? Fuck yes. Am I going to play it? Fuck no. It's ass. Actually, you know what? I might play this card. I'll be the first one on YouTube to make an Amphibious Bugroth deck. You know, just make it happen. That'd be pretty freaking cool. But if Konami, you know, decides to keep remaking all these old, you know, Umi-related monsters, giving them retrains, I think the only ones we're missing at this point is, I think, Deep Sea Warrior and Mermaid Knight. I think that's it. But, I mean, if they retrain those, that'd be cool. There's going to be so much, you know, Umi support that there's going to be a lot of different builds. So, you know, a lot you can really do. So, guys, aren't subscribed, go ahead and harpoon that subscribe button. Really helps channel out. Harpoon that like button as well. Comment any comments y'all have. Link in the description down below to my Instagram if you want to follow me on there. And I'll see you guys in the next video.